Agility is Special F, and I'm from FF Germany, and these are my contact data. FF Germany is, or FDM, is a leading GS provider worldwide, and GRS, I don't know if you know it, GRS is Geoinformation Systems, and ArcGIS is our robot, but this won't be an advertisement show today. So ArcGIS is software for visualizing and analyzing geographic data, and we have about 1 million users worldwide. But why should a GRS provider have a talk at a joint conference? So geoinformation is all about location, and we know we all have a mobile device, and there we can have and we can look up our location. So in former days, when we wanted to plan a trip, we just used such a desktop tool to plan the trip in advance. Nowadays, we can just use our mobile device and ask where we have to go to and which road we have to take. So we can do this while we are having a trip, in contrast to the former times where we had to do it in advance. So mobile and location belong to each other. So mobile devices are designed by nature for location-based applications. And so we all have mobile devices, and why don't we use it now? Or why do we only use it for the simple applications like where am I and where should I go to? So the mobile application, mapping applications are needed for decision making. At first we have data, and then we have maps where we can show the data on. And then we can have analysis based on this data, and we can visualize it on maps. Then we have a lot of geo tasks. I will show you some of these, but this is only geo selection. At first localization, you all know, where am I? This is really important for us. But who's already developed a map application with your current location? Please raise your hands. Okay, some of you. So this is a very basic one for mobile applications. Then we have another geo task, mapping. So we have to show our location on the map so we know where we are. Without the map, our location isn't useful at all. Then we have imagery. Imagery is these are photographs of the world, and they are often used in the maps of the world, for example. And these are just some examples for layers we can use in our map, and we can have semantic layers or other layers, like here. Then we have another task, it's geocoding. Normally everybody uses geocoding to ask where is something on a map. This is an example, where is a station in Berlin. It's quite an important task. Then another task is routing and navigation. We distinguish routing and navigation in the following. Routing is just a calculation of the route. Normally we use routing for planning in advance, and then navigation is using this route while we are on the trip. So the application navigates us through the world. Then we have data storage. We have to store our data, our geospatial data, in a database. Mostly these databases are optimized for geospatial data. And for example, we can use PostgreSQL to put GIS, for example. And then we have editing. Editing isn't used so much as just localization. So OpenStreetMap is a very prominent example for this. There, everybody can edit the features of our world. And who has already offered an editable feature service for their customers in their app? Please raise your hands. Okay, these are only 2 persons or 3, and localization or the localization task was used by more people here in the audience. So another geotask is geospatial query. So geospatial query and geospatial analysis. So geospatial query is used to ask, am I near near something else? And here are some examples, for example, aggregate points or summarize something, or you can have spatial analysis to aggregate some points here in some areas, or to and you need very good tools to use this. Or you can calculate the flow direction of water. If water falls down, you have to know where it will go float. And these are complex tasks with spatial analysis. Another example are find a location for your new factory. These are streets here, and we want to build a new factory. And then our factory must be near of a street because we have our trucks have to reach the next highway. So if not, the factory must be near the streets. And it must be near a river to have cooling water. So we have we draw polygons around these rivers to find a location. So these might be locations where we can build our factory. But then we have a neighboring country where Thermor is. So we don't want to have our factory near this country. And so we have to draw another buffer. And at the end, we have only two locations where we can build our factory. These are complex spatial analysis to find a new location for our factory. And who has already used such spatial queries and spatial analysis in mapping implications? Okay, two of you. So this is advanced stuff. Another tier task, tier enrichment. We can have statistical data or demographic data and enrich our data, for example, interest data with this, and reuse both at the same time. Another task is geofencing. It's a quite new task, especially for mobile devices. And here I want to show you a short demo demonstration. I hope this will work. And I have to open a browser. One moment, please. Okay, here you see somebody is going through a city, and every time he enters a geofence, he gets a message on his mobile phone. So this is one example for this geofencing. And now we need to go back to the presentation. And I hope this will work. And Nutitech, for example, they had a presentation So there's a complexity. At first, this is our core, and then we can consume data or content or APIs. We could extend the API, so we could build new algorithms to have more complex analysis. We could configure our content or APIs, for example, Redbox. Redbox offers you to configure your map, to change the colors, change the level where the layer is. We can edit our data, or we can process it, or just consume it. And we can have online applications or offline applications. And for example, there's an offline editor where you can put your data on your device, and you aren't dependent on the internet connection anymore. And then you can build applications on the cloud infrastructure. For example, CloudDB uses the cloud infrastructure where the your data is in the cloud. Infrastructure on-premise, for example, ArcGIS. Here, this is, for example, relevant for military applications because they can use the public internet. And then we have closed applications or open applications and single ones and APIs that are more powerful. So these are the different degrees of complexity, and you can. We can come from no customization to low customization and high customization. So this is a spread of customization, and it's time to explode this potential. And there are typical examples. So we have the content, the APIs, and the infrastructure. And I will show you some examples for this. For example, for content with low customization or non-customization is an out-of-the-box map. And a routing service from a provider. You just use it. It's just a consumption. And you need a permanent internet connection. And then content with low customization, for example, you can change the colors of your map. You can configure your routing service, for example, if you want you can say, oh, my truck has this height and this weight. And, for example, you can render and navigate offline. For example, you host your own map, you edit your map offline or synchronize it as soon as you have the internet connection, and you can set up your own routing service with your own network, for some sort of pedestrian routing or for truck routing and so on. APIs, you can use a simple template for the provider. You just have to configure the map extent, for example, or with a higher customization, you can add additional algorithms. Develop your own routing algorithms. And then infrastructure, you can come from the cloud to on-premise applications. And these were some examples. And then we have to think about the potential we have here. We have a mobile device and we have the world and the location. And why, how could we use our location on the device and enrich our apps at mobile mapping applications to our normal apps? And we have all these geo tasks we can use, and the different degrees of customization. So most of the people use only localization, but spatial analysis are very important for solving problems in the world. What are the technology trends? For example, inter-navigation. There are some providers here at the TrendCon that offer inter-navigation. Most of the people don't use it at all. So they have to develop or to improve their applications. And then augmented reality. For example, here at Nokia City Lens uses augmented reality to show you some points of interest. Or Metallio, they were there yesterday on the Republica. They used augmented reality, for example, for Volkswagen to show the future color of a car. And 3D is also an important trend nowadays. For example, Newton Tech can render these buildings on a mobile device. Or for example, ArcGIS has a city engine where you can build these buildings. So what's the conclusion? We have all mobile devices here, and why don't we use the location? And we have the content, the API infrastructure. It's all over there. Mostly it's free. Why don't we use it? And here. time. So if you want to hear more about this topic, just meet us there.